and me getting up from the table after 2 minutes because I couldn't take it anymore, and going to have a drink and eat some broccoli and roasted potatoes.
Oh, you know what?
You guys are funny, though.
Why is that?
Because the three of you. Three peas in a pod.
Well, I asked him a question. I said, is Chris Christie going to run for president?
Right.
And Chris Christie supposedly said, you know, if he won for the
White House, he'd
beat him right now.
Because I don't know if I want to be president, but I know I'd win.
And think about it in that
Get
world.
Get a little cocky, Chris Christie.
In the conservative world right now, you have a lot of rising superstars in Chris Christie. Unfortunately,
that's right.
You know, so a lot of people don't believe in what he's talking about, but, you know, to a lot of people, they do believe what he's talking about.
By the way, I didn't realize that Bill O'Reilly was as tall as he is.
Very tall.
I'll write it, and we'll do it live.
All right, you'll do it live. I also, he didn't, you know, I don't know about him.
Why?
Like, I appreciate the fact that he actually came up to me and said, you know, he listens to the show all the time.
Yeah.
And I know he's a big sports fan. He's got season tickets at the Garden, right?
That's right.
You don't get the sense that Bill O'Reilly lets his hair down much.
No, he's very...
You know what I mean? And that's fine. I mean, he's wildly successful. I mean, you got to totally respect, you know, the guy is the most watched, you know, cable news guy there is, right?
Right.
But I'd like to, you know what I'd like to do one night?
What?
I'd like to have one of those guys' nights out.
Right.
Where what's said here stays here.
Mm-hmm.
And I want to see O'Reilly, like, let his hair down.
He's not going to do
Throw
it.
Throw a couple Bushmills backs. You
not
know what I mean?
No. You want the Chaminade. It's not happening.
Maybe bring a loofah sponge, something like, I don't know.
A loofah sponge?
Yeah, you know, we'll go to a spa together, all of us. Smoke cigars, drink Bushmills, tell old war stories. He'll remind us what it was like hosting the Current Affair back in the day
right.
when he knew he was better than that. You know, all the good stuff. You know what I mean? Monica Crowley looked good, too.
She did look good. He
Shocking.
Actually says to me yesterday, who's the hot blonde sitting with Bill O'Reilly on
That's
there?
Right.
Well, that's Monica Crowley.
I go, that ain't Monica Crowley.
Yes, it is Monica Crowley.
It was,
Crowley.
Though, huh?
Yes. Mm-hmm.
She can really grow on you. You know what I mean?
I know what you mean.
I'm just saying, attractive woman.
I sat there with her for 3 days right here on WFAN.
Did not have as big an engagement ring as I thought she might have, though. Woman of her stature.
I know, she just got engaged, and congratulations to her, and not Bill O'Reilly, but her fiancé,
Bill. Fiancé,
Bill.
Hopefully Bill won't register at Citibank, but it looks by the size of that ring, he needs to.
No, he's not going to register at Citibank.
Think he's a wealthy guy?
And I'm thinking
maybe it was a family heirloom, because it's not a big ring.
You and I might get invited to that wedding, I can tell you that.
You'll get invited. I will not get invited. Monica adores me, by the way.
You think
but
so?
I see Monica once a year, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
She ain't going to invite me to the wedding unless she's just...
What was the with Darrell Revis in the glasses?
He had the smart glasses on, and he had the Revis Island shirt on.
I love the Revis Island
shirt. Yeah, I like
shirt.
That, too.
I mean, I almost ripped it off of him last night.
We asked him about the NFL lockout last night, too.
He
goes, I don't know what's going on.
He goes, I have nothing to say. I just want to play football. I'll let right. the other people handle the matter. I was smart. I said, just stay out of it.
It's nice, though, huh?
He looked good, though, didn't he?
I did. I thought I looked good.
No.
I rocked out the green cargo pants last night.
Who else?
By the way, I had an experience last night.
You also met somebody else. And then the other thing that you had your experience, you're screaming and yelling at because you didn't want to show up in jeans.
Right. I had a very awkward experience yesterday afternoon.
Yeah.
On Fifth Avenue because I didn't want to be a bad guy. Boom and I were going to a place where they go, there's no jeans allowed. Now, the last time I was there, I wore jeans. And no jeans. So I go, all right, let me be a good guy about it.
And get cargo pants.
And I'm going to get pants that aren't jeans. I wasn't going to go buy slacks.
They weren't pants. They were cargo pants.
So first I go to the Gap. I go, what man shops at the Gap? No one. The Gap's for children, right? I'm not going to go buy chinos at the Gap because it's garbage.
I buy Gap jeans online.
Of course you do, right.
Yeah.
I mean, thus you're on the team known as the Wasps,
right?
All right?
Yeah. Okay.
Which, by the way, lost in the championship game 6-4. Nice job.
It was not the Wasps.
Way to man up on that one, by the way.
Team.
You think I forgot about that?
I pulled the Gabrick.
Here you are.
Show up. I didn't
Big Boomer Esiason doesn't score a single goal in a 6-4 championship game loss.
Uh-huh.
Where were you, Captain?
Oh, I'm not the captain.
Uh-huh.
That's
you sent out emails
team.
Like you were. Step up, man up, big game.
Yeah.
You were scoreless.
Shut up no and just tell us your story about your
Plus
cargo
minus,
pants.
Plus minus four.
And you show up with a...
So my wife tells me...
You look like you belong on a TV show Oz last night.
So my wife tells me there's a Abercrombie and Fitch over there on Fifth Avenue.
Oh, there we go.
I like Abercrombie and Fitch. I love their soft, flannel button-downs, because that's how I roll, right? I actually bought one. So I go into Abercrombie and Fitch. Let me tell you something. I don't know what's going on over there at the Abercrombie & Fitch.
Yeah.
They got like some underage sex slave trade going on over there. So I walk in. There's.
Could you hear yourself talk in that place?
I go in. It's a boom, 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 boom. I mean, like I'm in a club. It's like I'm in One Oak.
Right.
And I'm waiting for Amar Stoudemire to show up and Jay-Z spinning records, right?
With the smart glasses.
Dude, it's louder than anything. Bump, 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 bump. You walk in. There's five anorexic models standing in front of you, right? Half the guys have their shirts unbuttoned and their abs are ripped up, just hanging out. Welcome to Abercrombie and Fitch, right? Like, listen, if I liked guys, I would go to Abercrombie and Fitch every day for lunch. These dudes are hot, right?
They got ripped up abs. These they got ripped up abs.
You got ripped up abs. Welcome to Abercrombie and Fitch.
Look at my abs.
Then you got these 19-year-old anorexic broads who haven't had a burger since they've been three, right? Welcome to Abercrombie and Fitch. May I help you? I'm like, what? What? Hold on, right? So then,
come on, bring it up, baby.
This one guy comes up to me. Stand up for a second, if you don't mind. Just for a second, stand up.
Stand up for a second.
So I go in. I go. Listen, I just need a pair of pants. That's all I need. I just want pants. And then I get this. You ready for this? Come up to me. They start dancing on me. I go, is this a club or is this Abercrombie & Fitch?
Hello, what size are you?
Right, the only Abercrombie & Fitch I've ever been to is in a Jersey mall. You know, with a couple Jewish high school girls standing at the counter. Welcome to Abercrombie & Fitch, right? So I'm in this club. I'm very uncomfortable. I don't like the shop. I feel like Mark Sanchez at an all-you-can-eat poo-poo plaza with 17-year-old girls there, you know, going nuts.
Yeah, that's right.
All right?
Yep.
So I go, and I'm like, oh, I go,
do they have anything that can fit you?
They have nothing that fits me. They're like 35. Ha ha! Stop eating, fatso! Get a pair of pants there,
right.
Unless you're anorexic. You know what I mean?
I hear you, brother.
So I buy my flannel shirt and I run out of there.
They have bed bugs.
But I think they did in the past, didn't they?
Yeah, they had some bed bugs.
So again,
why are you out of bed?
Because I was grinding on you. So I wound up getting a pair of cargo pants up the street. But the point is this.
Where did you get your cargo pants? A diesel?
Yeah, I did. It's on 54th and 5th.
I mean, so how about...
I went to Diesel. You go to Diesel, the guy walks into the dressing room with me. I go, listen, Ace, I'm 42. I don't have what you're looking for. Not that I'm bothered by that, because I just want to make sure they fit right. So I got a pair of cargo pants over there. And then I go, I might as well get a shirt while I'm here, too. The guy gives me a shirt. There's no way that shirt matches these pants, right? So I go to, I go, are you sure this matches? He goes, oh, yeah, by the way, here's my card. I get a 20% commission, so go buy everything. You know what I mean? So I go to check out. There's a very attractive girl at the checkout counter. And I go, let me ask you a question. I go, does this shirt match these pants? She goes, no. I didn't think so. So I only bought the pants
there. Well, you know, all I know is.
But quite an experience on Fifth Avenue yesterday.
So you show
up a bunch of European tourists. But that look, the look, it's the Abercrombie and the Fitch. We go dance on each other and buy small pants that don't fit. I mean, every guy's got junk hanging out of his pants. His abs are all ripped up. You can't get a pair of 35-inch waist pants. And then they mock you because you're older than they are.
Right.
But I will say this, and a memo to Al, Loopy Loops, and everyone else out there that's single. If you like dudes, if you like chicks, if you're a chick that likes chicks, I don't care what your sexuality is.
Right.
Everybody that's single should start having lunch over at Abercrombie and Fitch.
I mean, do we have any other verse to this song that's driving me nuts?
Boomer, I swear to God, I want to
turn that off, please.
I want to take you into this place. It is.
I've been in a place. I know what it's like.
It's like an underage club with no booze.
It's unbelievable.
There's got to be sex over there happening nonstop. I got three people, like, you know, gang attacking me with some kind of funky dance on me.
You ever see their catalog?
Oh. Yeah.
Yeah.
I like the catalog.
A little risque.
A little bit.
I like girls that wear Abercrombie and Fitch.
I do.
I will say this, though.
Told my wife I'm never walking into a store ever again.
So Craig shows up last night, and I know this is a big deal for him because he was having a meltdown yesterday about what he was going to wear.
Brutal.
And then you had to decide, you know, how you were going to go shop for yourself because you never do
that. And that's after I had lunch at Ollie's.
I thought you were going to take that metrosexual Alan Lippman with you.
Well, I loaded up on Chinese food for lunch, so you know I got a belly walking into Abercrombie & Fitch, and I'm burping General Tso's chicken on everybody.
And you probably swolled up because you got all the salt and the MSG with it, right?
What a terrible experience it was.
And no, I but at the end
dude, I bought a double XL flannel shirt that's tight on me.
And then you show up last night at this place where you can't wear jeans. Yeah. And he walks in.
That's right.
And I'm saying, man, it looks like he just came off the dock from fishing.
Well, they'll probably and show a photo of it. I'm wearing a black wool hat.
I mean,
I have
ridiculous.
A Bushmills vest on, green cargo pants. Black Uggs.
And sucking on a lollipop.
And I'm sucking on a lollipop.
He wears his Uggs last night without socks.
Yeah.
Well, because he does.
I'm wearing them right now. Look,
he always does.
Yeah. I wonder why Johnny Mack looked at you like, what is this?
Yeah, stuff? Johnny Mack's 50 wearing a hat backwards, limping. Shut up.
Yeah, he won, though, when he was winning.
He was DQ'd. He walked off up 6-3.
Yeah, he was killing Ivan Lendl.
He was limping, though. I'll give him that.
Look at you.
That's a look. That's a look.
That's right. By the way, I have not enjoyed a lollipop as much as I enjoyed the lollipop I had last night. You know, the lollipop is an underrated candy, by the way.
It is?
Yeah.
Look at you.
I mean, look at the guy in between us. He's having fun. I licked that Tootsie Pop like I was going to the chair.
Yeah, you were looking at her.
That's right. Next time I go to Abercrombie Finch, I'm going to have a lollipop.
Look at those
mouth.
Tight diesel cargo pants you
That's
have
That's right.
On there.
What do you got, Jerry Recco? You've taken far too much time.
With Chauncey Billups out because of the sore quad, others stepped up and lead the Knicks past the Hornets.
Carter. Back out Williams, sets for three. It's good.
And Sean Williams, three of the 16 off the bench, 11 in the third quarter. Mike Breen, MSG, New York beating New Orleans, 107-88. Big night for Tony Douglas, started in place of Billups. Douglas, 24. Plus, he held Chris Paul to just 4 points and 2 of 7 shooting. Douglas physical with Paul and at work.
I just didn't want him to feel so comfortable out on the floor, you know, make him work for whatever he gets.
Amari Stoudemire, also at 24, tells Douglas when the trade was made last week.
You should watch Chauncey and just kind of take notes from him.
That's right.
Because with this being your second year in the league, you know, you really can learn from veteran players like that.
Mike D'Antoni loves seeing guys like
well,
Douglas.
Tony Douglas had a great game, but he also, I mean, he was like Jameer Nelson the night before in Orlando. What was he, 10 or 13, you said?
Yeah,
I mean,
fire.
Ridiculous.
There's a point, I go to Boomer at the game, I go, look at the five guys on the court right now for the Knicks. It was Jeffries, Williams, Douglas, Mello, and...
Carter.
I mean, that team won big
by 19.
Because they did not have Mello and Stoudemire out there a lot together. Because obviously they want to make sure at least one of them was always on the court, as Boomer pointed out.
Right. The Knicks now 31-28. Next up, a home game against the Cavaliers tomorrow night in the Garden. Some NFL owners taking part in labor talks Wednesday, but it doesn't look like things are going well. The current CBA runs out tonight at midnight. Two sides to meet again today. College basketball, number 3, BYU, loses to New Mexico 82-64. Brandon Davies kicked off the team for an honor code violation. Reports say he had sex with his girlfriend.
Oh, no.
This is a major no-no.
It's funny, when you compare all the other violations that have had kids kicked off teams, it's usually like B&E, robbery, drinking and driving, drugs, gun possession. He had sex with his girlfriend.
Yeah, right. But remember one thing, guys, is that they have an honor code at BYU. You know what that honor code is. You read the honor code, you sign the honor code, and you say, I believe in this, I will adhere to it. And then when you go against it, there has to be a penalty or has to be ramifications.
Right, but it's a little harsh.
It's not for me. I'm not sending my kid there.
Right.
And I'm sure that, you know, it goes on all over the place. We understand that.
You just got a feel for the kid. I mean, well, how old is he, 19, 20? What is he? I don't know.
Right about that, yeah.
I mean, it would make it, to me, it's even worse. I don't know if it's worse. Is it worse if he makes love with his girlfriend, right? I'm going to assume not for the first time, but I honestly don't know. Who the hell knows, right? And then what if, like, his guilty conscience took over, Boomer, because he really bought into the moral code and all that stuff, which I'm sure they all do, right?
Right.
And what if that he turned himself in and went to the AD and said, listen, I have to be honest with you. Last night, temptation took over. I couldn't help myself. And I made love to my girlfriend for the first time.
Right.
Because, you know, that was inside of me. I had to tell someone. Is that worse? Or is, like, the guy on the floor next door got woken up by the heavy panting and moaning, ratting him out to the RA worse?
Well, it also says that I believe in the honor code. I have not read the honor code, but what I've read in the articles about this particular story, that if you know of somebody that has gone against the honor code,
rat him out.
It's up to you that you have to go and you have to bring that forth. So I don't know how this all came about. That I don't know.
Tonight, St. John's will take on Seton Hall. Now time for a game that I always like playing.
It's Boomer and Cartons. What the hell was that?
I like
this
game.
Is this A, Jacques Lemaire after a Devil's win?
No.
B, Brandon Davies' girlfriend? C, Luis Castillo stumbling about making another mistake?
Okay,
hold on,
relax. You just ran right through that, dude.
Yes.
Let's hear the choices first so we can properly prepare our brains.
Process them. All right, A, Jacques Lemaire after a Devil's win. B, Brandon Davies' girlfriend.
Okay.
C, Luis Castillo stumbling to reporters after he made another mistake at second base. Or is it D, a pig? Are you ready for the sound?
Boom, are you ready?
I'm ready.
Pig, Daniels, Jacques Lemaire, mm-hmm. and what was the other one?
Mm-hmm. Luis Castillo.
Luis Castillo. Okay, now I'm ready.
One more time.
Is that Jacques Lemaire, Daniel's girlfriend of
Davies
BYU,
girlfriend, yeah.
Davies' girlfriend of BYU,
right?
A pig, or Luis Castillo? All right, that is Davies' girlfriend in the throes of passion, recorded by a roommate who ratted them out.
I say Jacques Lemaire.
No. Boomer, good
damn
job.
Damn it, Boomer.
That's why he's getting so much money.
I don't know what noise that is that he just made.
That's a human being making that noise?
Yeah, that's Jacques Lemaire.
Amelia Kupchuk scoring another goal.
That's why he's getting so much money.
What is an ecclesiastical endorsement? Any idea what that is?
Sounds like the Bible.
Religious. Sounds like a religious thing.
Well, I'm looking at the honor code statement at BYU. Well,
it's, Eddie?
Be honest, live a chaste and virtuous life, obey the law and all campus policies, use clean language, respect others, abstain from alcoholic beverages, tobacco. May I finish?
Every single one of these.
I couldn't go to BYU.
Right.
Tobacco, tea, coffee, and substance abuse. Participate regularly in church services. Observe the dress and grooming standards. You know, you're not allowed to have a beard if you go to BYU?
Right. Oops.
Encourage others in their commitment to comply with the honor code. How about that? I don't like this
how
at
about
all.
That?
I don't like it one little bit.
Spring baseball. Yankees beat the Astros 6-5. A.J. Burnett and Jabba Chamberlain pitch well. Susan Waldman with Jabba after the game, trying to see if all that fat talk surrounding Jabba was accurate.
You were the first person I saw in the clubhouse, and I said to you, stand up. Let me see that body.
Yes! That's why I gotta love being involved in a locker room.
Oh, my goodness.
Let's hear it again, Jerry Reynolds, so I get the full feeling of the full frontal that Susan was looking for.
You were the first person I saw in the clubhouse, and I said to you, stand up. Let me see that body.
That's right. Pretend we're all working at Abercrombie and Finch, and let me see those ripped ab muscles of
yours. Everybody having a good time out there?
Oh, baseball is back. Willie, Mickey, and the Duke. Hey, A-Rod, remember when I first saw you in the locker room? I gotta be honest, A-Rod. I said it to all the guys. I said, stand up and let me look at your body. Here it is again.
You were the first person I saw in the clubhouse, and I said to you, stand up. Let me see that body.
That's right. I'm starting to sound more and more like Liza Minnelli as I get older.
Would you sign my balls for me?
Sign my balls for me, please, Alex Emmanuel Rodriguez.
Alex has special balls.
Special balls, and I saw them while he was playing Fungo. No pepper games. Now listen here. You tell that Carton to stop mimicking me. I'll ask him to stand up and take off his clothes. And I'm not going to like that, I can tell you. What? Who did she say that to? What's going on here? Hey, Sweeney, let me see that tight, supple ass of yours. Oh, I like it. Sweetie, you're going to break a story once in a while, why don't you? Oh, John. You know him, John. You know him and you love him. There's a lot of men in there we love, John.
I get excited just hearing your voice.
That's right. So take off your clothes and let me see your jog strap. There's a 3-2 to Gina. Gotta foul that one off, John. Let me hear it again.
You were the first person I saw in the clubhouse, and I said to you, stand up. Let me see that body.
Stand up. baseball is back in George Steinbrenner's box.
Who'd you say? Let's do it.
Jabba.
Oh, that was the Jabba. Oh, that's disgusting. Jabba, take off your shirt. Let me see your flab.
Susan. Oh, that's right, Susan. You did say that to Jabba, didn't you?
I've been working on my Sterling.
Yankees raised to the import charm.
I mean, I can't believe she actually asked him that.
Let me hear it again.
You were the first person I saw in the clubhouse, and I said to you, stand up. Let me see that body.
No! I mean, it writes itself sometimes, folks. It writes itself.
I mean, I feel so bad for her.
I know.
I do.
Can everybody hear me out there? What a great... I can't wait for March 31st. Yankees, Tigers, Susan, and Johnny. Oh, it's going to be great.
Can you hear us okay?
Yeah, we can hear you.
It's Cardinals today. For St. Lucie, Oliver Perez to start. And TMZ says Dwight Gooden will appear on the next Celebrity Rehab.
Well, he must be in desperate need for cash, huh?
He has to.
Pay about a couple hundred thousand bucks to be on that show. And the only reason to go on that show and embarrass yourself to America is for the cash.
Whatever happened to Rachel Yucatel?
She's cured.
Rachel Yucatel. By the way, there's an article in the paper today. It was the Daily News or the Post. You know, they do the real estate section every Thursday.
Yeah.
Where she is trying to unload her apartment, this and that, and then she's willing to rent it, too, for like $8,000 a month, some ungodly amount of money for a rent, right? But they wrote in the – you have the paper there, Booms?
What?
Yeah, right, Booma? Booma, I want to see your supple ass, too. Come on, you hunk.
How hard is it?
Well,
what paper you want?
Give me the paper with the real estate section in it.
Give me the Daily News. Okay.
Hand it to me, please. I don't want the Modell sporting goods thing. I want the Daily News.
Well, look at the sales at Modell.
Give me the Daily News.
Up already.
I noticed immediately you look stronger in your upper body and your shoulders, particularly in your chest.
Oh, come on. Jesus, God. I mean, my head's going to explode. Wow. What's this? Charlie Sheen is living the life, boy, isn't he?
Yeah. What do you got for real estate here now? Come on, what are we talking
about? So, in the paper today, right?
Yeah.
I read every paper front to back every day. It's what I do. It's part of the process of getting ready for
the
show.
That's the process.
Let me see the Post, will you?
I thought you said
you wanted
the Daily News.
I don't remember which paper it's
in. Darrell Rivas with Spike Lee.
Give me the Post, will you, please? So the point is, they write in the paper today, and not like it's been alleged or people believe it. They write a definitive statement that Rachel Yucatel received a settlement from Tiger Woods. Now, we've all thought that.
Right.
We've suggested she probably did, which is why she refuses to reference anything on the record.
Mm-hmm.
But here it is, page 42, Home Buzz, in the Jennifer Keel, Give Me Shelter column, which you get on Thursdays, right?
Right.
Yucatel, who received a settlement from Tiger Woods last year, bought the apartment for $1.625 million in the fall.
Okay.
That's a definitive statement. It's not, we think she bought it. She might have bought it. They're saying she got the settlement.
All right.
I don't know. Just thought that was interesting anyway.
Well, that also could be them, leading to a leap of faith.
Maybe. So she's got a three-bedroom, three-bathroom joint, 77 Park Avenue, listed for $1.95 million, 1,600 square feet. She bought it for $1,625. She's trying to make $300,000 in a year. I don't know. New York real estate, you think she'll get it or not? Probably not. She'll probably take a little loss on that. $100,000. What do you think?
So, she's not going to sell it for less than it's worth.
Well, she's trying to rent the joint for $8,900 a month, down from her asking price of $10,600.
And where is it?
77 Park Ave. I don't know where that is in Park.
What's
it downtown,
across?
Isn't it?
I don't know.
Yeah, it's downtown. Gotta be downtown.
Park Avenue.
Because I was at 720 Park yesterday.
Right.
And that's in the 50s. So it's downtown.
Union Square area?
You all right?
I'll tell you what. I'm just so glad that baseball season's back, man.
I'm pumped. If you're a bold man, you just sound like one like Susan.
Carton is brought to you in part by WeatherTech. Don't wait until it's too late. For complete protection of your vehicle's interior, shop WeatherTech.com.